Hallelujah. Young people, there's nothing wrong with dancing for Jesus. But we can't forget where we come from. So if you don't mind, let's have a little church right now.
Something about that name.
Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Listen.
Something about the name
Jesus. Something about
the name Jesus. Something about the name Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Yes, sir. It is the sweetest name.
Sweetest name. I know.
Lift your hand.
something about the name of Jesus. I mean, y'all through praising him already? Like the music went off and y'all sat down. It's still his name. Now, it's still the name of Jesus. Every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess. The Bible says demons tremble at the sound of his name. My God. Amen. No. Nothing like the name of Jesus. It will keep you when you can't even keep yourself. It'll strengthen you when you feel like you're weak. It'll stand you up when you feel like falling. Something about the name of Jesus. I'm sorry this morning. I don't have a Mother's Day sermon. So I just want to tell y'all Happy Mother's Day. Amen. Let's get that out the way. Happy Mother's Day, mothers. Amen. Let's get a Lord a hand clap of praise. But I do have a word. It just happened to fall on Mother's Day, so you're going to get this one, okay? Genesis chapter 22, verse 1. Genesis chapter 22, verse 1. We're going to preach through 19, but we're going to just read verse 1, okay? We're going to preach through 19. The whole chapter, amen? Y'all look at this. It says, after these things, God tested Abraham. Abraham's faith. God said to him, Abraham, and he said, here I am. This is only a test. You may be seated. This is only a test. It's only a test. You're going through. It's going to be over real soon. Keep the faith. Don't give up. It's just a test, people. Life is nothing but a series of tests. We've been taking tests since we've been breathing. Am I in here? When the babies are born, they pop them and test to see if they're going to cry. You remember? Well, she can cry. He can cry, right? It's always just a test. Don't make this more than what it really is. We was in class this morning. I said, you know, we can't even have fun at church anymore. Because we're so serious. Why are you going to be so serious when it's just a test? We think we wrote the Bible. We go to school and start thinking we so profound. Is everybody ready? When we preach, we got 12 Bibles up there to show you. We got them all, and they're all saying the same thing. Life is just a test. And, I was tested last night. After posting pictures of my mama and tears start to flowing. And he said, remember, this is only a test. You say you trust me. How many don't say it there? You say you love me. You say you believe in me. So I'm going to test you to see if what you're saying is true. Or are you just bumping your gums? You know what I discovered? A lot of people are just bumping their. Now there are some things called pop tests. I don't know about you, but when I was growing up, we had some homework. Well, these kids don't know nothing about that because they don't do homework. Teacher walk in and say, you do your homework? Yes, ma'am. You turn it in? Yes, ma'am. Did you understand it? Yes, ma'am. Okay, well, put everything up. Then pull out one piece of paper. And we're finna see if you know what you say. The test is not there to hurt you. The test is there to validate you. To see if you know what you say. You know, oh, I love God. I love God. I love God. I love God. What's wrong with you? I love God. You don't love God? What's wrong with you? We get to singing these songs and we're talking about how much we love and depend on him. He said, okay, pull out a piece of paper. Pull out a piece of paper and let me see how much you really love me. Oh, I trust God without a shadow of doubt. Okay. We're finna see. I think Joy Priest, she talked the other day about this, a test, and I was going to change my message. She said, no, she's New Testament, you Old Testament. She, when Peter got out that boat, his test showed him he didn't believe what he said he believed. See, the moment something starts happening to you and you leave God, you lying. The moment something starts happening to you, you need to go get you a drink, you lying. Drink the drink cause you drink, not to help you with your problem. Uh-oh. Smoke your weed for recess, not for medication. Sleep with your woman and man cause you like them, not cause you're trying to get over something. Uh-oh. Well, amen, y'all. Oh, this is a real church here. If y'all ain't been to no church, we talk about sex in this church. That's how these kids got here. They didn't get here by no osmosis. They got here by having S-E-X. Now you let the teacher teach your kid. You don't know if they saved or not. Then you look at me funny when I'm teaching the kids about sex, and I'm the preacher. I'm going to teach you what thus said the Lord. We going to always have a test. To test. Let me give you the biblical definition so y'all won't think. I'm looking at my boy on the end. I go to the Bible. It said tests are a means by which a soul is measured as to its fitness and proven out by its own actions. I'm testing your soul to see if you fit to walk in the kingdom. And your actions prove if you are or not. Oh, y'all don't hear what I'm saying. Yeah. Now we gotta take. Now when I got my license, yeah, I got license. I got my life insurance license. I got investment license. I can do all the stuff them big time people do. They just won't talk to you. I'll talk to you. You won't even talk to me. All right. See, them big boys won't talk to you unless you got $25,000, $30,000, $40,000, $50,000. So they ain't talking to none of y'all. I went got a license to talk to you about $25. You spent that last night on your 3-5. You spent that last night at the Spirit Store. Getting you a couple of bottles of that Stella Rosa. Black. Oh, that what's that other one, that new one that just came out with? What was it? What she said, Taylor Point. Taylor Port, no, that's the cheap stuff. Now I had, man, I tried that Taylor Port. That tasted like Mad Dog 2020. Man, the last time I drunk some Mad Dog 2020, I got so drunk and I looked at this girl. I said, "Ooh, you real ugly." Oh, y'all ain't never took no drinks. All y'all burping right now. All y'all burping. Some of y'all praising God slow because that weed done kicked in. Amen. Amen. Sitting there talking about, hey. Sitting there talking about, won't he do it? He sure will. Yeah. Having this many kids, you got to smoke some weed. They call her Mary Jane. They say she a real friend. Here I come. I went to a Saturday to Sunday class, and it was boring. But I needed the license to make the money. See, when you got a when you're trying to get somewhere, it don't matter what they put in front of you. I got to go where I'm going. Oh, y'all ain't took no testing. Every time we got to move another grade, it was based on the test that we passed. Test of 60% of your grade. They give you 20% for showing up, 20% for participation, and 60% for grades on tests. Tests are important. You know what I discovered? The only time you complain about a test is when you ain't ready. When you done studied and you prepared, hey, you ask me what you want at me, I'm ready. But those that haven't studied, those that have that are not ready, they don't know what's on the page. Pull out a piece of paper. Now, Father God, we come now asking that you bring back things. Hallelujah. To my remember, stop. It said bring back things. To my remembrance, not give you things. It can't bring back nothing you ain't put in there. Cause nothing from nothing leaves. You gotta have something if you want to pass the test. But it's just a test. Ain't no talking in the test neither. The text opened up says after these things. What things? I'm glad you asked. What things? After Isaac was born, weaned off his mother, after Ishmael and his mama had to be put out for the second time, after God had to tell Abraham to let him go, promise him, I got them. That ain't the promised child, but you slept with it, but because it's your child, I still got him. His name is Ishmael. I'm going to take care of him. He's going to be the father of a nation. The Arabic people. We still deal with them today. But Isaac is the chosen one. He's going to be cause you to be the father of many nations. And God takes care of his. I got half sisters and a brother. I'm the one that let Bully know he could have kids. He didn't know what he was doing, but look what he created. Snuck that girl out of class. Yeah. And had me. I got four sisters and a little brother. My brother's younger than all my kids. They had to call him Uncle Junior. Who is it? This my uncle. You're rocking your uncle. Yep, daddy started late. He's still doing it. Met that old young gal. Hell, I'm older than my stepmom. Don't you tell me God ain't bad. I'm probably the only one that treated like she my stepmom. I don't care about me being older than her. He love her, so I love her. How about that? See, it's the test to see if you who you say you are. Are you going to hold grudges because he wasn't there for you? Or are you going to be the one that passed the test and go on with your life? Now I counsel him. Now I'm his best friend. I'm his mentor. How is it that the daddy becomes the mentor? Because the son becomes the mentor to the daddy. Because it was a test that I passed. Let me tell you how I passed the test. See, y'all real say, y'all ain't never done nothing. You know, y'all ain't never. Sister, turn around in the white. Give me some. I don't know who you talking about, because, boy, I had a thought this morning. Sitting right here having a thought. What is he talking about? So me and my dad wasn't hanging around. This my test. And boy, I say, boy, when I get him, who I'm going to cuss him at? I got some words. I was telling, I don't even know if Bully remember this. He bought me a pair of boots when I was about seven. And I said, Mama, something wrong with these boots? Well, he got a 5 and a 6. And I wore a 6, so that 5 boot was hurting. So I'm sitting there talking about, Mama, I don't know what's wrong with the boot. She said, let me see. She said, boy, here's your problem. One of them a 5 and the other a 6. I said, he must have been high. Bring me a 5 and a 6. But here's the problem, y'all. I didn't want to give them back. Somebody say why? That's the first time he ever bought me something. And I was in the 7th grade. I was 7 years old, 8 years old then, so I know if it took 8 years to get a pair of boots, it's going to take an eternity to get them back. Because guess what? I never got them back. That's why I want to give them up. Fast forward to being grown. I'm going to get to this text. I'm talking about me. I said, ooh, I'm going to get him. I got some stuff. Some of y'all going to get free today. I got some stuff I'm going to tell him. You ain't never been there. You sorry. You this, you that. And I'm going to say MF and SOB, FU, down you, round you, around you. All that. I had it. And he would never meet me to it every time. That's going to lie. Oh, I ain't going to lie. I told him, I said, one day God going to fix it. To where ain't nobody on this earth but me and you. Church. And the day came. You know, my dad and me and him saying we love cars. And he had a Lincoln. Got towed. And couldn't nobody loan him $70. I said, no, I'm going to give you this $70. Can I bless your game? Real tests that change your life cost you. They ain't free. Uh-oh. Ooh. See, the test that cost you will change your life. Uh-oh. See, I got a life insurance license. I had to pay that. It changed my life. I got investment license. It changed my life. You understand what I'm saying? Mary's a nurse. She paid for it. It changed her life. The test that cost you will change your life. So I have him pull that money out. I said, yeah, I got this 70. Because I'm going to tell him. We had to wait an hour. You want to go eat? Get whatever you want. I got it. Get whatever you want. He ain't never been nowhere. Give me 5 pieces of fish, 2 pieces of chicken. I said, look, he just stopped. He don't know what he's doing. Sit down. Remember? I said, yeah. I'm finna tell him I got it. He done paid for his car. We just waiting on him to release it. We done ate. Well, we're eating. And we both hungry, so we're not finna waste no food. I said, yeah, thank you, Lord. I get to cuss him. You know how some of y'all lie on the spirit, talking about the spirit get, you know. You know how some of you lie on the spirit, talking about, you know, the spirit done got me ready to tell you a piece of my mind. The spirit ain't going to tell you to tell nobody a piece of your mind. Carla, that was me. That was 36. I was 30. That was 36 years of buildup. Drunk my drink. Open up my napkins. Clear my throat. The Lord say, tell him you're sorry. I say, hell, I ain't done nothing. Come on now. Wait a minute. I didn't even ask to be here. He didn't give him a boost back. And I finally get to tell him. I almost had a coin on my left foot. Because the boot was too little. Never came to nothing. Never gave me nothing. The Lord say, tell him you're sorry. Girl, you in my mind. I said, God, now what I do? What am I apologizing for? He said, tell him you're sorry for talking about him. And he don't even know what you're saying. Tell him I'm sorry for calling you all kind of names and didn't know the whole story. Yeah. Well, See, because what you got to understand on this Mother's Day, you got to know both sides of the story. There's a mama side and a daddy side. And whoever you live with the most is just going to tell you they side. Oh, y'all didn't expect this from a mother, did you? Your mama going to tell you he wasn't nothing because she mad because he left her. Most of the time. Because when you 14, 15 years old having sex, let me tell you, young people say something. Don't have it as long as you can. Because once you start having sex, it convolutes everything. My mama mad because he didn't do. He said, I just came to have sex. I didn't know nothing about being no dad. I didn't even want no child. Your mama was fine and she said, yeah. I said, yeah, that's how I got my boy. Ain't that how you got your girl? Ain't that how you got yours? He looked good and it wasn't nothing personal. I didn't want nothing from you. I just wanted to do it. And can I get some amens? I have amens over here. Some of y'all say it on that side. Now he got on that muscle shirt and he buffed. He ain't got no stomach. You didn't know he was driving his mama's car, but that didn't matter. He was putting gas in her car for her. With her money. But he looked good to you. And because you're so immature, you saw with your eyes and not with your soul. And you laid down and it was over. You weren't looking for no kid. You just having some sex and a kid popped up out that thing. Sarah told Abraham, go on in there and sleep with Hagar. Come on, Dad. Just go get you some, because it ain't working. I mean, hey, we've been waiting for a long time, but don't get no. Menopause done set in. It don't even work no more. And you talking about God say we finna have a child. The Bible said she laughed in her spirit. And God said, I heard you laughing. She didn't say a word. Do you hear me? See, the person that writes the test makes the question based on what he want to answer to. Uh-oh. See, when you make up the test, you make it up the test to prove what you want to know. Uh-oh. So since God is giving the test, what's Abraham's name means? The father of? And he's the father of faith. Uh-oh. So I got to put up a test to test his faith. Uh-oh, y'all with me. So when I test his faith, I'm going to see if he who? He said he is. I'm going to see if his soul is ready for the assignment. Uh-oh. See, a lot of you haven't been used by God because you ain't passing the test. Your soul ain't ready for the calling that's on your life. So he had to let you wander out in the wilderness. He got to let you go through stuff. As he's steady preparing the test, you got to go through something to get the answer to the question. Which means you got to spend time in your book. You got to spend time studying. So when you spend time studying, you can't help but to study yourself when it's you. So here it is. We met. And it's been on ever since. He said, man, it wasn't my fault. I'm sorry. Well, what do you say when they say I'm sorry? I didn't get one of them cuss words out yet. I mean, he done already got emotional. Listen, he done got spiritual. Hell, we supposed to argue at least 10 minutes. Can we argue? I just need to argue for about 10 minutes. I don't know about you. This is what I said. I just need to tell him something. Can I say one cuss word? God, let me just say, God, hold on, God. Can you give me a bonus question that I know the answer to? Oh, y'all act like y'all never asked for no bonus. You know you finna flunk this test. Is there any bonus questions? You know, when you ain't ready, the first thing, yeah, do we have any extra credit? Any bonus in here? Because you know you ain't studied. You lying like you ain't never been through nothing. You acting like you better than what you are. And you know when this test show up, you finna get your head bust wide open to the white meat because you ain't ready. Can somebody say ready?
Ready.
Say, I ain't ready.
I ain't ready.
That's why you stay where you are.
Wow.
You can't advance till you pass. Y'all wasn't ready, y'all learning along the way. Tell me, y'all had to go to school immediately. You 15 with a baby. What you look? You should have told me, what the hell? What you do with this? Them 12 minutes cost me this? Oh, you weren't doing too much. You just started. Some of y'all still learning. It ain't as good as you think. You met these. Oh, I ain't going nowhere. I'm gonna leave this on a good day for the women. We ain't going. Don't do me like that. I'm finna go. Beep. Let me back this thing up. So Andrew, oh, happy Mother's Day. I'm sitting at the table. Say, man, he's sorry. Hell, he's crying. I don't need no tears. I want to say something. I'm like, okay. Here I am. Okay. I say, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, too. Why are you getting uglier than me? Let me help y'all out with something. This is free. When you have children, do whatever you can to not keep them from their father or the other parent. See, I didn't need nothing. I didn't need monetary stuff from Bully. No, you sit back there. Sit up there. Sit up. That's my dad. He's sitting. That's my man. Sit on down. I didn't need his money. I just need to know who the hell I am. Why I act like that. I was sitting over there talking to him one day, and I'm just sitting there looking at him. I'm like, hell, that's where I get that from. Oh, okay, that makes sense. So my anger level went down. My disdain for him went away. I passed the test. We passed the test. Let me tell you how I know we passed the test, because I led him to the Lord. I baptized him, his wife, and all their kids. But the Lord said, now, if you'd have acted a fool, and I know you won't act a fool. I know you won't tell him. 37 is when I started my relationship with him. 42. Somebody say 42.
42.
Was the first time he ever told me he loved me. And it's 53. That's my dude.
Amen.
But it was because I passed.
Amen.
I counsel people. So if you ain't never been through nothing, nobody want to hear you.
Right.
Tell me how to get past this. This is what I did. And it worked. After these things.
Yeah.
I wish they're going to be out on time. It's Mother's Day. Y'all get to go. I'm getting in line. I'm about 3 or 4 is done. I'm staying focused. I'm not going over there with them women. I'm not going over. I'm going to stay right here in this text. Happy Mother's Day. I'm trying to stay there, okay? Then God said, verse 2, take your only son, Isaac. Watch this. Not any son, the son you love. And go to the land of Moriah, kill him there, and offer him as a whole burnt offering on one of the mountains I will tell you about. He said, get up early in the morning. See, he had to say early in the morning because the woman sleep late. He said, don't wake her up. It'll mess up what we finna do. Leave her sleep because she'll be in her feelings. That's a baby. She was 95 when she had him. She ain't finna hear nothing about him finna die. She ain't finna hear none of that. She don't talk about nothing about what God gonna do. Just leave her sleep. Cause you see how these women went, all them boys called their mama up here, and all of them lost it. Boy, them boys had them mamas wrapped around their feet. She just cussed them out coming to church. And I want my mama to come. Them boys. Kill them mamas and them girls. Destroy the daddies. I ain't nothing when it comes to my daughter. But I just tell you, she know it too. I saw it the other morning. She said, "That's my daddy." She was sleeping. Come out the room with no clothes. Go put some clothes on. I heard your voice. I said, "I know it. It's that effect." I said, "Go get your boy and go kill it. Just go to Moriah and I'll tell you which mountain to go up on. This is the one y'all waited for. This is the one you stood firm on. Yeah, you slept with Hagar, but that was flesh. Don't you know you're going to miss at least one question? If it's 10, they give you 3 to miss. Because all you need is a 70 to pass. See, some of you won't finish the test because you missed number 2. Now it's 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Finish the test. And let the teacher grade it. You won't even take it because you missed number 1. Get up. Early in the morning. Take your boy. The one that I told you is the promised child. The Bible says, and kill him. And offer him as a whole burnt offering. On the mountain I will tell you about. Here's where the faith kicks in. Somebody say fake kiss. Abraham didn't lay down and had no pillow talk. Some of your clowns mess your game up because you roll over and tell her. He didn't tell you to talk to her. Hey, baby. You rubbing feet. Isn't it your girlfriend right there? Is your girlfriend right there? Don't things change when she get to rubbing in them braids. Come rub on that braid. Rub. Oh, hell, his head done already started. Why we'll trip behind women? We got the I can't habits. When I get to him, I just need to ask God one question. Why he made that so good? Boy, that old girl get everything. I mean, she get everything. She get the car, the debit card. Then you marry him. People talking about it's cheaper to keep her. No, it was cheaper to leave her alone. Don't go to the room and leave. Don't be saying I do and stuff. They get the best car. All the pillows. Most of the closet.
Lord have mercy.
Man only got 2 bands.
Man, I built me a closet on my side, Rem. She took that too. For them 6 minutes, boy, they everything, boy. Them 6 minutes. You know why it's 6? Because I knock out in the second round. You know, it don't even take the whole second round. Give me about 4 minutes. I'm going to knock out. I'm 39-0. With 38 knockouts. One of them I had to go the whole 12 rounds and die. You need to start laughing at yourself. You're giving yourself too much credit. Just look at Ram, just look at yourself and just bust out laughing. Yeah. A whole baby come out that woman. What you talking about? 19 inches, 10 pounds, 4 ounces. Boy, what you doing? Well, nothing. She just line making noise. Get your boy and go kill him. Verse 3. Abraham got up early the next morning and left. Got his ass and two servants. Went to Moriah. It's in the text. Ass is in the text. Y'all say it, it don't mean what y'all say, but it's in the text. It's a donkey. He found the mountain, dog. What's your name? Darius. Look at her boyfriend named Darius. Look at him. She don't like him. She don't like him, but her boyfriend named Darius. Stop that. Let me see what happened when I say Darius. Look at she blushing at him. Boy, them Darius is something. The text says he did exactly what God told him to do. Laid there, can you imagine laying there knowing you're finna kill your son? Can you imagine laying there and your wife don't know? But see, when you have faith, you don't have to tell her everything. I know the God I serve. He tell me to do it, he gonna fix it. When he got to the mountain, he told the boys, y'all stay down here with the ass. Me and my boyfriend go up and worship. We will. Oh, come on. See, he didn't say I'll be back. He said we'll be back. See, when you got faith, you got to walk like you know it's already done. You got to know that if God tell me to go kill him, he got the same power to pick him back up. He promised me some things through this boy. And if I go kill him, he breaks his promises. And God does not break his promises. So whatever God tells you to do, get busy doing it. Because when you move, you tie his hands. When you stand still, you show you don't have faith. But when you operate on faith, you say without faith, it's impossible to please God. That's why he comes to the church. Because faith comes by and hearing by the word of God. How can you hear? I don't care if you don't like me. I don't care if you like my delivery. This is. See, he called me to be me because I'm in the hood. See, I can't come here being on proper with these ghetto folk. These ratchet folk, we got to fight. You know, we all packing pistols, don't even matter. One woman talking about I slap preachers. I say, hell, I shoot him. I shoot you back. I wish you would raise your hand up to me. I'm not your hub, but he got them knots on his head because he's a punk. I'm grown. And I'm going to tell y'all something. You think it's the men, my women, to kill you. My real goons are my women. Because they done been through a whole lot. They put their makeup on and look like they ain't been through nothing. But they will tear your head off and boo-boo down your neck. They get you talking about, hey, man, how you doing? Good to see you, baby. You doing all right? I mean, straight violent. Be talking about, hey, baby, what up, my nigga? Take that wig off. Gut him. Stand up, John. Stand up, John. Stand up, baby. She comes straight from the streets. You better not mess with me. She here. She got the goals in her mind. Every one of them goes. Just let you know. She from them streets, man. Tattoos. Stand up, blue black. Stand up, black. Don't let that red hair fool you. Her last name, Black. She ain't got no sign. Don't you mess with her.
Well, for real, though.
Stand up, Carl. Taylor. Stand up. Now you think she's sweet. Look how she's looking. She's smiling right now. Would tear your head off, sister.
Well, for real though. For real though.
It's a test. All right. To see if you have what you say you have. A test also lets you know what you need to work on. See, we're going to see what you know, but then the test lets you know some areas you need to improve in. It don't mean you're a bad person. You need to go study a little more. So God said, I'm going to put you through a few more trials so when I come back with this question again, you can pass it. Because I need you ready when I stand you up. Go up the mountain. Told the guy, y'all stay here, we'll be back. See, now you wonder why we follow Abraham. You wonder why why the struggle was so hard for Abraham, because he's finna change the world. Because to be saved, you got to have faith. He's developing faith because the gospel ain't gonna make sense. That a man would be born of a woman, the daddy didn't even, the man didn't even touch her. The spirit impregnated her. This doesn't make sense. But if he developed their faith before it happens, they'll believe it. Because as he went up the mountain, Dr. Martin E. Hawkins says this. He said, I believe that every step Abraham took on this side of the mountain, Jesus took it on the other side of the mountain. And as he climbed that mountain, Jesus was climbing that mountain with that sacrificial lamb. But he said, I can't say nothing. See, let me help you this. Sometimes you're not doing anything wrong when God don't answer you. It's testing time. I've been in school all my life and it wasn't no talking when you're taking a test.
All right.
Talking suggests you're cheating. Well, y'all cheating because you're talking too much.
Cheaters.
Sometimes you got to think. You got to be quiet so the spirit can bring back to your, if you're talking while the spirit is talking, you're going to miss that question. And all teachers, you, they don't want you to fail. Take a test, Andre. Teacher walk by and kind of read what you're writing. They just kind of point at this one. You know that one. As a matter of fact, that's the one you answered yesterday when we had the review. God, hey, you're moving too fast. Slow down. Be quiet. Think. Read the question. I promised you Isaac. He's now here. I tell you to sacrifice and kill him as a burnt offering to me. Why would I tell you that? Because I'm testing your faith. Do you trust me like you say? And the only way I can see before I release the power to you is test you on it. See, you want that new car. Ain't ready. Test. Will you wash it? Test. Do you get the oil change every 3,000 to 5,000 miles? Test. When you hear a noise, you cut the radio down or up?
Come on, Doc. Come on,
God says, when I send this noise bullet and you turn the radio down and start listening, you ready for something new. But when I send the noise and you cut the radio up, you ain't learned yet. I want this 3-bedroom house. You won't clean up the raggedy 1-bedroom shack. Clothes everywhere. Roaches shooting dice. Rats are serving the food. You're not ready. See, folk with roaches know what I'm talking about. Them rats be talking about, man, did you hear that noise? Oh, that's George. His plate over there. See, when we were growing up, Mama didn't wish we would go to sleep in that kitchen ain't clean. Man, you been there asleep. Wow. I thought while slavery was over, they got that whip. Get your butt up and clean my kitchen up. That's how you get roaches. Go to your house, you know why you got roaches? Because you always got dirty dishes in your sink. That's why they been in the microwave. If you throw the microwave away, you're going to get rid of them because they've been there waiting on that food you're leaving there for 2 days. You're flunking. How you know? Roaches are there. Because wasn't no roaches there when you got there. I want a new car. No, you don't. You ain't thankful for the hoopty. My first car was a beat up Nova. A wrecked Nova, but you couldn't tell me nothing because I had one. I washed my three rims, sprayed my black rim where it shined to match the car. Now I used to go with Bullet House, he had all them pretty cars, well, let me drive now. And I say that. But that beat up Nova turned into a Chevette that I bought. So now I had two cars at 15. Had a car, y'all, that wouldn't, boy, that wouldn't work for nothing. God didn't like me with that car. I had to practice 460. Four windows down, going 60 miles an hour. Sweating. You know what I'm saying? Had that velvet interior. That crushed velvet, I mean, it just hold heat. But on faith, I start calling for things that be not. As the Lord, thank you for this old beat up car. It ain't got up, but I'm riding. So I watch them say, yeah, baby, keep on riding. Because one day, you're going to turn into a Mercedes. I'm going to be able to ride it and lean with it. Rock with it. And roll. Do you know God turned that thing into a silver Mercedes? S430 sitting on them things. Big old seats leaning, AC blowing cold. To this day, you can't get in my car with that off. Don't touch me. Hey, get out. Get your coat, you ride with me. I'm going to have it on and it's going to be on. What's wrong? I remember when I didn't have Earl. Don't you do something to remind you of where you came from? Isaac wasn't a boy neither. See, my Isaac said, Daddy, what's up? We done this before. I see the altar. I see the wood and the rope. But I don't see the sacrifice. That was one of them bonus questions. God will provide. He had to comfort him. God will provide. Hear what I'm telling you. You can't see, he had to say it on faith. Thank you, sir. He had to know that he know. Because watch this. Y'all forgetting. He was 100 when Abraham was born. When Isaac was born. So he know God can do something. It took him 25 years to have Isaac. You know why it took 25 years? Somebody say why? God said, I want to make sure you're dead. Your reproductive organs, I need them dead. Go study. He said, I need the womb to not work. So you can't take no credit in Isaac being born. So what nothing working on her or him? Ready, boy, you better go sleep. Nothing. Works. God said, now it's time. Oh, y'all better get this in this word. See, this word is so bad. You're so ready to go eat. That food ain't gonna be good. He said, God said, that's a joke. Come on. He talking about my cooking. I'm not talking about your cooking. Anyway. Q cute. He said, ain't no parts going to work. Some of y'all don't even know when to shout. He's drying your money up. He's drying your credit up. He's drying your job up. He done dried Boo up. Boo 2, 3, and 4. The Boos are on ice. Joy! He said, I'm finna dry it up! So can't nobody take credit when I bring you out. See, can't nobody. Some of you may, well, he left me. Baby, you ought to be shouting. It's over. Praise God, because God has something more for you. Whatever you had took you as far as you can go. And where you're about to go, they don't have the oxygen capacity to hold where you're going. If a snake bites you, just go higher. He can't breathe higher. They'll fall off. Some of your people are falling off because of your elevation. See, he said, I ain't going to take you to the valley. I'm going to take you up to the mountain. I'm going to take you higher where blessings are. I'm going to take you where I dwell in the spirit realm so you can receive. Some of you are afraid to go up because you used to be having trash at the bottom. Trash don't rise. It don't go uphill. Trash only goes. And God is telling you those people, places, and things are trash in your life. Instead of me telling you that, I'm just going to tell you to go climb the mountain. See, the boys couldn't go up the mountain. The servants had to stay down. You don't get to see this blessing. You don't get to see me move. Stay down here and we'll tell you about it when we get. I don't know about you. When I go to conventions and I go talking nothing about money, people say, how what? I say, I can't explain it. It's like eating banana. You just got to eat the banana. I can't explain to you what happened because what I got wasn't for you. Because you weren't there. Yeah. Now, if you were there, we can come back and talk because you saw what I saw and we can share what God gave both of us. But he didn't give me the nothing to come tell you. Yeah. Faith is personal. Yeah. Faith is an individual walk. Yeah. My wife ain't going to be there. My kids ain't going to be there. Your spouse ain't going because his was at home. He called him the father of faith, not them. Oh, y'all missed that. Y'all missed that. She got to eat because it was him, not her. Come on, son. Let's cut the mouth. Me and you. Read the text. It said he see, when you got faith, you ain't worried. What the hell are you having an anxiety attack for? And God spoke. Why you guys? Why are you pulling your hair out? He spoke, and you're going where he told you to go. Come on, son. Everything gonna be all right. Don't worry about it. Y'all stay here. We'll be back. Do you see? Do you see the test? Stay right here. We'll be back. This is the mountain. There it is. He told us to go right here. God showed me. We gone. Here we go. We're starting up. Now we're starting up. This for me and you, Isaac. This ain't for the servants. This ain't for your mama. This ain't for nobody but me and you. And we're constantly ascending.
They supposed to be down there.
Here's what your problem is. You want them to go. He didn't say they could go. You dragging that bum or that bumette. You can't make them see God. Hell, they'll tell you they see God so they can get what he done gave you. How you going to deal with him? He meeting God with you. So he ain't got no plan for y'all. He's just sexing you down and sucking what you got. Because the woman is to help meet. What you going to help him meet? Nothing? Nothing from nothing leaves. Oh, I love him. You and your feelings, you don't love nothing. How you going to love a no direction person? How you going to love somebody that has no direction? So they don't even know where God is. So how you going to love them? They don't have a word for you. They can't keep you. They can't wash you. They can't protect you. They can't guide you. And you done sold your soul for a jelly roll and bit into it. And wasn't no jelly in it. You better keep on climbing. It's tough. It's supposed to be. Because what I got for you, and every time you try to drag somebody, you lose too. You got to keep climbing, people. God said, you're at the highest point of the mountain. That's right where I need you. Stop right there. So when he stopped, he was sitting there, y'all. Let me get out. I don't want y'all to be scared. When he stopped, Q, that's why I got out, because I'm going to laugh with you if I ain't hurt. Brown, when he stopped, he stopped moving, but he kept moving. He stopped moving because he found the place. But I got to keep moving so I can do what he asked me to do. He laid the altar down. Now, Jesus on the other side of the mountain looking. He laid the bar down. That didn't move him. He tied him up. Oh, I said, that ain't it. I ain't impressed. Because how many of us heard that song, Almost Don't Count? Bully. Abraham pulled out his knife. God said, that still ain't it. When he lifted it up, he said, okay, you're making me look a little bit. But when he was on his way down, hold on. See, you got to take the whole test. It was on his descend with the knife. The Spirit of God said, hey, don't do it. Now I know. Look to your left. And when he looked to his left. Now he had looked around. You know, when you're building that thing, you got to be looking around. Don't see nothing. Can I tell you something? When you build it, God ain't going to let you see. Because if you see too much, you'll stop. God going to let you look like you don't see nothing. I don't know what this is. I don't know why that's happening. But while you're building and doing what you're doing, and God is steady easing in, and when you stake the knife and be ready to kill the sacrifice, the angel of the Lord say, hey, now I know. Look to the left. You say, God, always. Come on, believer. Have your back ever been up against the wall? And that ram showed up. Have you ever not know how you was going to eat? Didn't know how that rent was going to be paid? Your car is broke down and it need money to be fixed. You don't have no money. You done borrowed all you can borrow from people. You owe everybody in the family, so you can't call nobody. You owe your light bill and get on the phone because you ain't afraid to talk. And you get on the phone and the operator say, well, ma'am, listen, I want to bless your game. We had a refund that we owed you. And it was $350. You owed us $325. So we're going to send you $25 and your lights are still on. Don't tell me God don't have a ram in the bush. Let me go and bless your game. Quit being afraid to take your call. You got bill collectors calling, call them and talk to them. They might be calling you with some good news, but because you ain't operating in faith, you won't even take the call. And what God has for you to show you that he's there, you're not getting it because you know you're armed and you don't have the money, but you don't have faith to say, ma'am, I don't have it. But it's in those moments that God show up and he show out. It's in those moments where God will step in right on time. Anybody know what I'm talking about? Because I remember over 2,000 years ago, I saw God in my spiritual mind sitting at his table looking and saying, who can I send to fix this sin-infested world? He said, the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. God said, who can I send? I can't send Abraham, Isaac, nor Jacob. I can't send Moses. I can't send David. But I see Jesus easing over as God was looking to say, Daddy, if you prepare me a body, I'll die for those people. I'll change the situation. God said, now boy, let me tell you, if you go down and die for these people, I'm not going to spare the rod. For the wages of sin is death. It's going to be rough and it's going to be tough. But because I'm God, I'm going to make a promise to you that if you go down and die for the sins of the world, I'll give you power on heaven and earth. I'm going to give you double for your trouble. I got a reward for them who diligently seek me. That's a message for you today. It may be rough. It may be hard. But go on, go on. And do what God told you to do. Because your blessing, your breakthrough is at the end of your assignment. Some of you are pacing the floor at night asking God, God, have you forgotten me? God, what am I doing wrong? God, I'm doing all I can. And God say, no, you're not. Because it's a 10 test question. And you stopped on number 3. Get your dusty self up. Pick up your pen. Go back to the table and answer the rest of the questions. I have prepared you for this test. I've wired it just for you. Because I'm sovereign. And because I laid your whole life before me. Before I created you, I'm going to tell you what number 1 is. Tell you what number 2 is. Tell you what number 3, 4, 5, and 6 is. Looking at the book for number 7. Recollecting in your mind number 8. Sitting down pondering how good God is. You will answer 9 and 10. Then you can sit back with tiptoe anticipation, knowing that this test didn't come to fail me, but it came to promote me. Am I right about it? Some of you are waiting on your promotion, but you won't finish the test. Some of you are waiting for your breakthrough, but it's a tie to the test. Because the Bible says that when Abraham did what God said, the angel said, don't do it. Now I know there is a ram. There is a ram. There is a ram in the bush. Go get him. Lay him down. Sacrifice him. Then go back down the mountain. Get your servants and let them see that you are a man of your word. Make them see God in you.
make them want to know the God that you serve. How is it that I go up a mountain realizing that my precious son, I got to kill him, but I'm trusting, somebody say trusting, I'm trusting every step of the way, because it's symbolic of Jesus nailing his hands, ribbing his feet. Jesus is the precious lamb. Jesus is the Son of God. Jesus, I wheel in the middle of the wheel. Jesus, I live in the valley. I bright and morning star. Jesus, I door into the kingdom. He died. Let me say he died. He died. But saving power, redeeming power, forgiving power, loving power, all power that was lost from the fall was restored unto man. Ain't he all right? Ain't he all right? High five your neighbor and say, neighbor, oh neighbor, neighbor, this is only a test. Good to the other side. Neighbor, this is only a test. Some questions may be hard in others. Some questions require a lower effort in others. Some questions are multiple choice. But God takes it all and put it on paper so that you can. Somebody say, I can. I can worship him in spirit and truth. Say yeah! Yeah! Oh yeah! Oh yeah! Now when you lead church, now when you lead church, you gotta lead church and tell God, thank you God for my test. Thank you God for my test, because my test is nothing but questions over how you kept me. My test is nothing but questions of how much faith I have in you. My test are nothing but questions of how you made a way out of no way. I'm so glad you love me, because eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, neither has it entered into the hearts of men the good things that God has in store for me. How can you say that? Because my test is my test. Your test is your test. Your results are your results. My results are my results. Thank God. Thank God. Yeah! Oh yeah! Oh yeah! It's only a test. Quit running from the test. Sit down. Buckle your seatbelt. Pull out your pen and your paper and start writing the answers to your questions so you can get what God promised. The doors of the church open. There may be somebody here that was thinking their life was messed up. He's just testing you. He's just getting you ready for what he's already promised you. If you here and you're out of Arkansas, you don't know Jesus in the pardon of your sins, or you've left him, today's a good day to get up, to come to him, just as you are. Give God a chance to show you how bad he really is. Give God a chance and watch him turn your life around. Because I know if he did it for me, oh, he can do it for you. 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 He'll reach up here and grab you. God is no respecter
Say, Jacob should not lose his reward. If you should die and miss heaven and go to hell, after a word like that, ain't nobody fault but your own. Stop beating yourself up and realize it's just a test. It's just a process that God puts in place to ensure you and him that you're ready. Ain't that so? It's only a test. Amen. It's offering time. Amen. My God. All right. Hey.
God, see if he's gonna give me throw you again. Father God, we come to thank you for the gifts. Bless the hand and prepared it. Bless those that gave. Pray that it's be used for the building of the kingdom. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Amen. Let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise. It's only a test.
Yeah.
Amen. You know what? You can't be afraid of the test. Some of you have test anxiety. You got to pray heavily when you go in. Lord, settle my mind and my spirit. Give me what I need. Bring back those things to my remembrance.
Yeah.
I've known some people that took their life insurance exam, Reverend Brown, 8 times. One guy in the office took it 13 times. But it didn't matter when he passed.
So then,
don't matter how long you take in the test, just keep taking it. And when you pass it, you're elevated to the next level of it. Well, some of y'all done got depressed. You done took that test 8 times. Go 9. Go 10. Go until you pass it. And how do you know you pass? Because he'll release some more things. He will release what he promised you at the passing. That's why people don't die, they pass. Because when they pass, they get all the stuff that God promised. So quit being afraid of passing. Happy Mother's Day. Wait, that's a good one, wasn't it? Well, grab their youth and women glasses be like this when I leave on Mother's Day. I mean, hair all over their head. I mean, they be like, y'all still got your makeup on today, boy. Y'all can go eat today. Anaya and Jermaine Beatty, stand up. Uh-huh, them Beatty's kids. Candidate for baptism. But they excited. Look at them. They just smiling. Yeah, them kids coming, man. Them kids coming to God. Let the little people lead you. She had hip surgery. She's steady trying to walk. She going to walk in a minute. Then you know we go back, so you tell me what we need to do to baptize, okay? If we need to put it on the bench or something, we need to just hold it and drop her down. She can stand and go down. Oh, what, you ready next Sunday? You ready next Sunday? Okay, we'll be baptizing y'all next Sunday. Shalonda London came back home. She said she's a backslider. She getting back right with God.
Get it right, boo. I tell everybody, just keep coming. You can't get it right not being here. Keep coming. When you fall off and he wake you up, get on up, come on back in here. We're going to score on you when you get here. You're good. Now, where you be? Now, we're going to make sure you're fine. Where you be? Don't take it personally. We're just showing our love. We show love like that over here. Jacoby Jones, he came for prayer. Amen. Won't God do it? Wednesday night, there were four people join church Wednesday. Children. See, long as children accompany, they'll never die. Your old people done got set in your ways. You think you're already going, so go on, go where you're going. But the new people, the little babies coming here, you can teach them. Don't come in here so smart. You got to come here like a little baby. And let the Lord use me to speak to you to get you in the fold. Because you may think you're there and you ain't. There are some people you think ain't ears. That means you got to look in that mirror and deal with you. Well, they do that. What you doing? You being a judge now because you looking at them talking about them. They smell like weed. You smell like a gossiper. You look messy. Acting like you sleep to send texts. Talking about the lady sitting next to you, texting your sister that's behind you. Stop that. Oh, we got to get out here. I'm sorry. Craig Renfro. Where Craig at? The dark one. We was in there talking about being dark in the men's room. He reached over the cue, told me, "You just as dark as me." Okay. This certifies that Craig Renfro was baptized in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost on the 14th day of May, 2023. Pleasant Hill Missionary Baptist Church. Tiki Brown and James Brown are his parents. Get busy, man. Let's get to work. Keep doing what you done started, okay? Y'all, I gotta confess. I let him back up. Cause he beat me in dominoes. I'm gonna leave him down now. Till we got to the little bitty bubbles. The Lord said, "Don't run him out before you get here." Okay, I brought him back up. He talking about, "That's all you got?" Stand up, boy. You take. Stand up. What's your name again? Come on, stand up. Stand up. Your friend. Yeah. You. Chris. See, when Chris came to this church, he was homeless. He used to sleep in his truck. He used to sleep in his truck. He came. Is your woman here? He got, stand up, woman. She told me, "I'm here." He told me, "I'm here, baby." He working, got his own truck, and finna get married, and brought his friend in, except to Christ. And you know the only thing we had to give him when he was homeless? The only thing we had to give him is just let him park his church on the park ground. His truck on the... Yeah, you can park your truck on the church, man. You good. Sleep in if you want to. Every time look up, see if anybody's breaking in the church. You know, just do something. That's how we met him. Because we finna get him. Hey, man, what you doing parking on the park lot? I'm homeless. Oh, okay. But come on, church. Come on in. That's when we had food, man. We gave him some food. We had soap and toothbrush and toothbrush. Go in the bathroom. Hair up. And we loved him just as he was. How many of you had to put on the front when you got here? You didn't have to, how many had to put on the front? How many of you didn't have to put on the front when you got here? You could be just who you were and watch God change you. Deliver me from these churches that you got to act like you got together. If you had together, you wouldn't need God. That's why I'm still the pastor, because I need him. Every second. Every minute of the hour. Come on by here, God, so I can keep preaching to your people. Yeah, that's the last one. Andre Henderson. I thought Andre was coming back to rejoin. This certifies that Andre Don Henderson was baptized in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit on the 14th day of May 2023. Present here at Missionary Baptist Church, Diane Collins and Thomas Mocklin are his parents. Amen. Let's give him a hand.
Thank you, sir. I appreciate it. That's it.
Hey, man, come on up, Reverend Brown. Come on up, Reverend Brown. Now, Reverend Brown, you remember we let him preach here when he... That's who? The leafy Christians. So you can tell you said something, they still remember. Let me tell you what they remember the most. You didn't preach long. Oh, yeah, we can remember the leafy preacher. He got on there to go on out. Yeah, he talked about that tournament that day. He talked about, and it was 2 hours. So tell him he ain't been to this church. He ain't been back. Or my folk go to sleep on you. But look at that, 11:30. We like them, you know, them. Yeah, we like them other people. It don't take all day to talk about God. But my friend called me and said, hey, man, I got some things I'm doing. I'm teaching a Bible study. And I got some people that need to be baptized. I said, come on. He said, what? I said, can she come Sunday? He said, what? It's a distribution hub, man. This God house. And a soul want to come and be baptized, and we going to act funny? So I'm going to give him the mic and let him introduce his member that he baptized and call her up and shake her hand and do all that kind of stuff. Amen?
You don't do that, Pastor.
No, that's you, Doc. Come on.
I love this dude right here. Listen. This is my cousin, Carol Onita Johnson. I'm gonna say this, but I know that, you know, this is a pastor mic.
Say what you say.
This certifies that Carol Onita Johnson was baptized in the name of the Father and then of the Son and of the Holy Spirit on this 14th day of May in the year of our Lord 2023 at Pleasant Hills Missionary Baptist Church of Edna Smith and Willie Johnson, of her parents. Amen.
And we'll send them to you. Let me hold your hat. She got that hat on. What's your name, baby?
It's Carol.
Carol, don't sit down. My folks didn't ask you for your dress and your hat. Don't sit down. She wearing that dress and hat. I wanted her head the size of my head. That ain't what I said. She looking, talking about, yeah, that's working. Because it won't fit no part of my head. I don't mess my cut up, man. I'd be. Whew. Let me have this moment. Those of you that were born in May, rest on your feet. Stand up. Yeah, come on. We got something for you. We got something for you. Today is her birthday. Oh, today her birthday. Get on out there, dance, girl. Get on out there. Go on out there. Yeah, take it out there. Get out there with the people.
Happy birthday.
Boy, she ain't gonna never forget this church. She done danced out at the church. Darius said he ain't gonna let his girl dance by herself. He holding her hand while she dance. That's enough. Boy, I tell you, we don't want her there. We know she yours. You good? You want a cupcake? Uh-huh. She's trying to pull me out the spirit.
Domino challenge. Domino.
Where you from, girl? Where you from? Singing Hill, Texas. Okay. I'm from a 200 block of Jim Miller. Woodland City, baby. The roughest apartments in the city. The Woodland City. Listen, dude, you can't be bringing this mess over here. We was in the spirit. The problem is she didn't get in the water. Ooh, Lord, have mercy. Deliver me from people that don't talk noise. I'd like you to talk noise to me because I'm coming. Amen. If you hear a word that don't fit, it fit. I'm still a pastor. Preach next Sunday when I get to cussing you out. Ooh, she talking about you cuss tones. Okay. You cuss. Can I prove it? Hey, you ever stomped your toe on the end of the bed? What? You say, oh, Lord. Then she lied in the chair. Anniversaries for May. Anniversaries for May. Give him a song, dog. See, they don't even have to cook dessert for you today. You see that? See that? You still get good stuff. Yeah, you got your dessert for today. With a big old strawberry. Oh, Lord. Mike's in there talking about, uh-huh. You ought to see Jad talking about Look at Mike, boy. I don't know who's my Lord. Bum dum bum de bum bum de bum bum. Baby de bum de bum de bum. Ooh. You want me to take the kids? You need us to take the kids? Cause I don't need them to be. I don't need them to see your dad. They dad like that. He talking about give me about 20 minutes. You come bring him right back. Oh, y'all are something else. I wouldn't pass to another place, boy. Now, there are some. She is dying. You are, what's your name? Mary. Who invited you, Mary? John, what's up, baby? How you doing? I don't put the baby to sleep. Right? I need about 10 more minutes. She'll be waking up trying to eat again. It'll be some cupcakes out there. See Aaron if you want one for a small donation. Ain't nothing free. Who ain't nothing free? Listen. Listen. Life is short. Get over the foolishness, man. Get on this race, this ride with God, and let's see where he takes us, man. Do we have any guests here for the first time? Just stand up and let us say hi to you. We ain't going to make you say nothing. Just stand up. It's your first time here. Amen. Praise the Lord. Now, y'all come give him some Pleasant Hill love. Pleasant Hill, show him some love. Amen. Give him a hug. Touch him. Let him know they're real. We love them. Maybe they'll come back. Amen. 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 Who they crying? Hey, hold on, nurse. Hold your hand up. The nurse gonna give y'all something. Yeah, there they come. I know y'all tired of laughing. It's time to eat. Happy Mother's Day to you, beautiful mothers. Thank you so much for all you do.
all hearts and minds clear, shall we stand?
God be with you. God.